Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss about fog computing. Fog computing is the new term which was introduced by Cisco in 2014. Fog and cloud computing are interconnected. In nature, fog is closer to earth than clouds. In the technological world as well, it is the same thing. Fog is closer to the end users, bringing cloud computing capabilities down to the ground. When we compare fog computing with the cloud computing, we can see that the number of nodes required to implement cloud computing is very less as compared to fog computing. However, when we talk in terms of security, fog computing has higher level of security as compared to cloud, and latency in the cloud is higher as compared to fog computing because fog is nearer to the end devices. Then why fog computing? Fog provides the missing link for what data needs to be pushed to the cloud and what can be analyzed locally at the edge. The development of the fog computing framework gives organizations more choices for processing data wherever it is most appropriate to do so. For some applications, data may need to be processed as quickly as possible. For example, in manufacturing use cases where connected machines need to be able to respond to an incident as soon as possible, fog computing can create low latency network connections between devices and analytics endpoints. This architecture in turn reduces the amount of bandwidth needed compared to if that data had to be sent all the way back to a data center or cloud for processing. It can also be used in scenarios where there is no bandwidth connection to send data. It must be processed close to where it is created. As an added benefit, users can place security features in a network framework and connected network traffic to virtual firewalls to protect it. Then why fog computing? Fog computing, it is used when only selected data is required to send to the cloud. This selected data is chosen for the long-term storage and is less frequently accessed by the host. It is used whenever a large number of services need to be provided over a large area at different geographical locations. Devices that are subjected to rigorous computations and processing must use fog computing. Real-world examples where fog computing is used are in IoT devices like Car-to-Car Consortium in Europe, and then devices with sensors, cameras. They can utilize this computing for enhancing their capabilities. Then where we can use fog computing, that is in connected cars. With the advent of semi-autonomous and self-driving cars, will only increase the already large amount of data vehicles. Having cars operate independently requires capability to locally analyze certain data in real time, such as surroundings, driving conditions and directions. Others data may need to be sent back to the manufacturer to help improve vehicle maintenance or track vehicle uses. A fog computing environment would enable communications for all those data sources, both at the edge and at the endpoint as well. Endpoint, here we are referring to the manufacturer. Smart cities and smart grids, they also utilize fog computing. These systems are increasingly using real-time data to more efficiently run systems. Sometimes this data is in remote areas, so processing close to where it is created, it is essential. Other times the data needs to be aggregated from a large number of sensors. Fog computing architecture could be devised to solve both of these issues. Then real-time analytics, a host of use cases call for real-time analytics. So real-time applications can utilize this computing for enhancing their performance. Thank you.